In this video, I'll guide you through the easiest and most convenient way to build group chats using open source models with the brand new version of Autogen Studio. Ever thought about creating your own army of AI agents to accomplish any task without writing a single line of code? Let's find out how. Honestly, I was somewhat hesitant at first when I heard about Autogen Studio. Why use a web UI to create agents and group chats when a few lines of code could achieve the same? But then I decided to give the newest version a try. I discovered it's incredibly enjoyable to construct complex group chats in just minutes. And I'm not referring to the basic Hello World examples. I'm talking about real-world applications, such as checking inventory for spare parts and creating customer support agents that respond in a specific voice and tone. And thanks to the built-in UI, sharing the results with peers becomes instantaneous, and even those who can't code can contribute to refining the prompts. I'll show you how to set up everything from scratch, and in just 4 steps, you'll master creating complex group chats and skills with Autogen Studio. As always, we start by first creating a virtual environment to clearly separate dependencies. We then activate it. We can already install Autogen Studio by executing pip install Autogen Studio. And after we have installed it, we can simply start it via Autogen Studio UI. And we see that Autogen Studio has been started and we can access it via the shown link. On the UI, we see various options like skills, models, agents, or workflows. Let's start by setting up our local model. We can see that Autogen Studio provides configurations for GPT-4, GPT-4 Turbo, and Zephyr. Let's delete the default models and start from scratch with a brand new local Llama 2 model. Let's change the name to Llama 2. We don't need an API key because it's running locally in this case. For the URL, we'll come back later because first, we have to install LM Studio and start a server. We can download LM Studio for Mac, Windows, or Linux easily. Once we have installed the program, we can download language models directly to our device via an easy-to-use interface. In the Server tab, we can select the Llama 2 model and start the server. We see in the shown example that the server is accessible at localhost port 1234. Let's adjust the URL in the model accordingly. When we click on Test, we can see if the communication to our local model is running successfully. Okay. It seems that the communication between Autogen Studio and LM Studio works like a charm. Let's save this new configuration. Next, we want to create a new agent. For this, we click on New Agent and give it the name Bob. Bob gets the system message that he loves to tell jokes and that he should improve the jokes after Alice's feedback. Afterward, he can end the chat with the word terminate. As a model, we add our local Llama 2. Now we can create our second agent, Alice. Alice also gets a system message. She should criticize Bob's jokes. We assign the local model again, and now we can already create a so-called workflow. So let's remove everything obsolete for a clean state. We want to create a jokes group chat. Let's adjust the group chat settings. We assign the agents Bob, Alice, and a user proxy to the group chat. As the speaker selection method, we choose Round Robin. This choice is due to the observation that the speaker selection process tends to perform poorly with small local models, making it preferable to have each speaker take turns sequentially. We name the group chat manager Manager, remove the agent description and system message, and then link our local model. Great, now we can already try out our brand new workflow. And we simply say, please start. Let's take a look at what's actually happening under the surface. The process has been started. Let's have a look at the LM Studio logs. And we see that the request has been received by our LM Studio server, and work is now being done on a response. Depending on your machine and the length of the response, this process could take a few seconds. It looks like the request is finished and wonderful. Without writing a single line of code, we've completely created a group chat where Bob told a joke and Alice criticized the joke. Before we continue, here's a quick reminder. If you like this content, don't forget to explore our free video series at aifordevs.com. Now, let's dive back in. To demonstrate how skills work, we want to start again with a complete clean state. And for that, here's the trick. We have a SQLite database file in the Autogen Studio directory. And if we delete this, we have essentially performed a factory reset and can start completely from scratch again. What I want to show now is how to create a skill that can access the inventory. We have two built-in default skills, generate image and fetch profiles. But we want to create a skill completely from scratch. For this purpose, I have prepared a file that returns the inventory. This is a simpler version of our inventory script that accesses a real SQL database from one of our last videos. You can find the link in the description. Okay, let's now create the skill, get inventory, and paste it. Next step is to assign this skill to an agent. We're going to start with a simple chat that consists only of the user proxy and one another assistant. We assign the agent the skill, and then we can already try it out. We start a new session and ask if a windshield is available. Let's take a look at the console and see what's happening behind the scenes. We see in the console that the function was successfully executed. Unfortunately, the output is still very technical and doesn't sound very good. Therefore, we want to create a group chat with an inventory manager and a customer support agent that answers in a very friendly way. For this purpose, we first create the inventory manager, who will be assigned the getInventory method so that he can check the inventory for spare parts. In the agent description, we specify his responsibilities. With the skill assigned, he is ready to proceed. And we also create a customer support agent who takes the information from the inventory manager and responds to the inquiry in a very polite manner. We assign no skill because here the capabilities of an LLM are sufficient for us. We create a new group chat and call it inventory group chat. We assign the agents to the group chat, namely the inventory manager, the customer support agent, and the user proxy. Then, in the workflow description, we specify that the customer support answers the query based on the information that the inventory manager has found. Okay, with just a few simple steps, we've completed our group chat setup and now have a small team ready to handle custom queries. Let's ask whether Tesla bumpers are available. And we wait eagerly. Let's take a look at the console and see what's happening behind the scenes. It looks good. And here we also see the friendly response, just as we wished. There are 5 Tesla bumpers in stock, each priced at $2,000. Just think, for the price of a small car, you can have a piece of a Tesla. Bargain, right? If you like this content, explore our free Autogen video series at aifordevs.com.